Hello, everybody, and welcome back to OMB Reviews. I am the critic who is a cynic. Hope you're doing well, and today I'll be doing another review in my Akira Kurosawa series of reviews, this time with the film Yojimbo from 1961, starring, once again, kind of, it seems, the muse of Akira Kurosawa, and that is Toshirô Mifune. Before going any further, though, please be sure to smash the like button, light up that fire button if you're watching over on Odyssey. It really does mean a lot. And so, yeah, I've been on a bit of a Kurosawa kick as of recently. As I've mentioned in previous videos before, before going on this kick, the only film of his that I had ever seen was Seven Samurai, which I saw several years ago. I want to say I had to watch it for a college course, and that was my first introduction into the world of Kurosawa. And I've always, ever since then, wanted to dive further into it, but because of just laziness and also getting distracted by newer releases and other movies that I had never seen before from the 70s and most especially the 80s, as people on my channel always like to remind me of, I just always fell by the wayside. And so I started to pick them up, the Criterion Collection editions of the various Kurosawa films, especially over the last year or two. A big influence of me, of course, has been one of my Valkyrie, one of my mods on the channel, Tina B. Thank you again. Shout out to Tina B, because she is a huge Kurosawa fan, and so she has been very much pushing for me to watch a lot of these films. And so I started off by watching Rashomon, which I really thoroughly enjoyed, then went on to The Hidden Fortress, which I also enjoyed, and now I've gone on to Yojimbo. And so I actually just started the sequel to this, Sanjuro, the other day, and I haven't finished that one yet, so I'll give my thoughts on that, which is interesting because apparently that film is a very different style, even though it features the same main character. It's a different take on it. It seems to be more like seen as like a comedic movie, where this one is a much more serious film in general. And so speaking to that, let me just start off by talking about the positives to this movie. Once again, you have a very, very good story here written, obviously in part by Akira Kurosawa, and it deals with a lone samurai, a ronin as they were known, just going around. And in this place, he goes to this town where there are two rival gangs that are fighting for control over one or the other, and he's just, okay, yeah, I'm here, and you know what, if you want to hire me, I'll gladly be hired for the right price. And it, again, a lot of other things ensue from this story overall, and you start to realize that the character played by Mifune is actually kind of has a heart of gold. You know, and we've seen this trope in so many movies, but it's always really cool to see what likely is one of the foundational points of that character, the one who is very hardened on the outside. But in this case, when there is a family that's impacted, when there is the wife of one of the members of the community who's not a part of any of the gangs gets kidnapped and is potentially being abused, he acts, right? He saves her. And so it shows that he's got this heart of gold. And when they're trying to thank him and profusely thank him, he's like, get out of here, you idiots, go away. Like, I hate you. And it just shows you, right, that he still has that hardened exterior, but he also has that heart of gold. And so it's always cool to see in cinema when you have these tropes that have been in so many other movies, kind of you see the foundational principles of those, or at the very least, some of the better iterations of those characters, because they don't try and do too much with it. And so I do think overall, I enjoyed that story. I enjoyed just how he is. Again, Yojimbo meaning the bodyguard. He's hired on as a bodyguard, and just the mindset that he goes through, that even though he seems to be rather lawless, doesn't take sides or doesn't want to take any sides, that he does still feel drawn to those that are seen as the good guys, or at least to those who are the innocents, right? In this turf war, really, he doesn't take sides with either of the gangs, because it doesn't seem like he likes really either gang in general, as is seen throughout the movie. And so the movie story, I think, is fantastic. Of course, the acting also is still spot on. You have another great performance here given by Toshirô Mifune. In this case, it's one of the first movies that I've seen featuring him where he actually at one point is beaten, right? Where he's actually at one point captured and beaten up. And so to see him play a bit of a more dramatic role in that way, to show himself being injured, I thought he did a very good job there. The fight sequences featuring him also are pretty great. Now, I think that obviously in modern day in the modern day cinematic world, you probably would have seen those sequences a little bit different. There's a couple of scenes where he just goes out, like, he just slices people up. And in today's world, right, you'd have a lot of dramatic music behind it, a lot of quick cuts and things like that. But I actually really enjoyed the simplicity of the fights because it, to me, seemed a lot more realistic, right? Where it's like, no, if you slice somebody, they're gonna essentially be dead. You know, if you slice someone across the chest and cut them open, essentially, they're not gonna have this, you know, dramatic keep fighting mentality. It's just like, no, they're just gonna be, you know, exactly, you know, they're just cut up, right? They're just gonna be on the ground dying at that point. And so I kind of like that simplicity there, though. I could see how some people, more modern audiences looking back to that, might say, I didn't really buy those, or I didn't like that. But I think it's because the modern audience has just been so trained to expect fight sequences to happen in a specific way. It's one of the reasons why I thoroughly enjoy, I guess, a more modern take on fight sequences that's somewhat similar to this style, I guess you could say, would be what we found in the movie Haywire, right, featuring Gina Carano, where in all the fight sequences, they don't cut away, they don't do a bunch of quick cuts, they have just the people on screen fighting. In that case, you have Gina Carano, who is a trained fighter, actually doing her own stunts, and I think that, again, Mufuni, based on what I had been, you know, seeing on screen, at least what seemed to be the case with the cuts, I'm pretty sure he did a lot of his own stunts as well. But also, you don't have a lot of stuff distracting in the background, because also in Haywire, they don't play music in the background. You just hear the sounds of the fight. Now, obviously, those sounds very well could have been amplified or could have been added in post, but it really didn't try and do too much. And I think that that's something that's really compelling about the style of Kurosawa, is that he rather lets what's being shown on screen tell the story rather than having all of this extra stuff that really doesn't matter, that really doesn't add anything to the story, you know, take precedent or distract in any way whatsoever. And so, again, I think the acting absolutely is very strong here as well. As far as the weaknesses to this movie, I definitely think this is probably one of my least favorite of the films made by Kurosawa. Again, I do like the story, but it's just not as, I guess, entertaining as some of the other stories that I've seen. You know, with Hidden Fortress, you have the two peasants who are hilarious, and there's just a lot of really awesome character dynamics in that. And this one, it really is focused on Mifune, who's a good person to be focused on because he's a very talented actor, but the relationships just aren't as interesting. The characters and that have a relationship with his Ronin character aren't nearly as compelling, aren't as interesting as what you had in the story with, you know, Hidden Fortress, with the peasants and with the princess and everything else. And I also didn't think it was as interesting as what we saw in Rashomon either, just because there are these differences in the characterizations and also in the relationships between them. So this is very much a movie focused on just the one actor, which, again, it's a good actor to be focused on here, but I do like, and I do think it's better when we have these other interactions, or rather, I think Akira Kurosawa's better films are the ones that feature more people interacting with one another, just like what you saw with Seven Samurai, where you have all of these different characters all interacting together, because he really does a good job at building relationships and developing those relationships. And this one had, I think, the least, at least from my own perspective on how I saw the film overall, but still a very strong movie nonetheless. Very excited to be going through Sanjuro, which I am enjoying so far as well. If I had to give this movie a grade, though, I'd probably give it an A minus. So all the other ones so far I've been given A's to, because they've just been solid. There hasn't been a whole lot of negative things to say, and there really aren't a lot of negative things to say about this movie either. It's interesting that apparently this was essentially ripped off or remade by Sergio Leone's spaghetti western A Fistful of Dollars, so I find that kind of interesting. Though, to be honest, as you all know, I'm not a big fan of traditional westerns in general, and something tells me that I probably wouldn't like A Fistful of Dollars nearly as much as I enjoy this movie here. And so, yeah, A minus for this movie. It's still a very, very solid film, but in comparison to the rest of the lexicon that I've seen so far by Akira Kurosawa, this I think might be my least favorite, just because it's my least favorite of the stories. But anyway, what are your thoughts about Yojimbo? Let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, smash that like button, light up that fire button. If you're watching over on Odyssey, you're all great. Today we will be having another episode of the Good Morning Asgard podcast exclusive to Odyssey. I'm actually going to be trying out a streaming platform called Melon today. It's actually based in and connected with Streamlabs, so we'll be seeing how that goes. And anyway, please consider joining those morning streams every Monday and Wednesday throughout this summer, starting at 8:45 Eastern time in the morning. You guys are all great. Have a wonderful day, and as always, God bless. And now for a huge shout out to all of my June Patreon and Subscribestar members: Andrew Hoyle, Bifford the Hobbit, Brian P., Dion, Don Bruno de la Mancha, Enrique Evangelista, Father Christopher Miller, hail to you, Father, Father Damian Cook, Garrett Searles, Inflamed Wood, It's a Trap Productions, Jason Clark, Jacob Juice, Jeffrey Toon, Jonathan Carney, Laura, the Modern Major General's Story, Mike Jackson, Mad Mitch Dunaway, Mr. Peabody and his evil twin with the beautiful hair, On to June, Orange Hat Reviews, Out of Step with Reality, Priscilla Hall, Riff Magos, Rosetta Allen, Teresa Martin, Theodore Benden, and rather Teresa Martin is Miss Martin Muses now, Tina Bogen, Tina B., and Washington Madranda. Thank y'all very much for being my supporters on Patreon. And to my Subscribestar peeps: Fast Reaction, Nosferatu Gatsu, Stand 4, John B., Perpetual Punster, Mr. Roy, Glinzer, J. Alex McCarthy Jr., Dean Heiss / The New Number 2, J. Ra, The Beer Guru, Nevanon G. Adams, and ZK Man. Thank you all very much for being my Subscribestar members. And if you want your name shouted out at the end of every video and live stream, please consider joining on Patreon or Subscribestar. You also get access at other tiers to things like a bi-monthly podcast, bi-monthly, bi-weekly, twice a month podcast that I do with John the Flick Pick Flickinger, which is a lot of fun. There's also a tier in which you can join me once a month for the Chosen of Valhalla live stream, where you all get to, at that level, join me for discussions, talk about any projects that you might be working on, or just hang out and have a good time. It's a lot of fun. And also, too, for many of those levels, you also get access to a giveaway section on the Discord server, where you get access to giveaways of things like 4K movies, digital codes, and tons of other stuff like that. So if any of that sounds interesting to you, check out the links in the description and sign up over on Patreon and Subscribestar. You guys are all amazing and beautiful people. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, God bless.